day. We're still here. We've all been here for about 12 hours. What a magnificent grand final, boys. Mate, Tigers deserving winners.
Oh, absolutely. I know it's been said a few times today already, but Laurie Nichols will be throwing the almightiest flurry up there, upstairs. Yeah. Mate, good on to him. Scotty Prince, outstanding stuff. And look, I've got to say Tim Sheens also. He's now in the class of a master coach. Well done. He ushered a young team to a wonderful grand final.
He's seen a better try than the one that Benji Marshall set up.
What about how? What an outrageous talent! Just to like the reverse flip.
It was like you at your best.
Bodacious or bodacious?
That was good looking.
We've now got seven different premiers in a row, and that just shows what a good shape I think our game is in. We're starting to spread the spoils around on the side like the West Tigers. Well, congratulations to the underdogs.
This show's about the best of the footy show. We've had another magnificent year. I want to thank our sponsors once again: Crazy John's and Jim Beam. Absolutely fantastic sponsors. Thank you very much.
Yeah, on behalf of the hosts, also want to say we've had a great year, very enjoyable. 12 years now the footy show has been on, and we've got to thank people at home for allowing us into their lounge rooms at 9:30 every Thursday night. Thank you for that. And a special thanks also to the clubs and the players who've made themselves so available, Matty.
And also, boys, Thursday night was just a huge show, absolutely sensational. It was just outrageous. We want to thank everyone who put the show together. Big thank you to you. A lot of work went in, and we had a ball like everyone else.
It has been a great show, and we love doing it. It's been a good year. We love doing the show. And, you know, at the end of the day, when it's all said and done, you know, you set out to do a couple of things, boys, this year. We've won the gold. The gold logie. We've got it.
And it's just a logie. It's not the gold logie.
Oh, it's not a gold logie. It should have been a gold logie.
All right,
but
boys,
it's been a great year.
On with the show, eh? Let's get it started. They're going to see everything good that happened on the show this year and plenty of
bad. Show.
Let's start off with fun we had on the set. Enjoy.
Love was out to get me. That's the way it seemed. Disappointment haunted all my dreams. Then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer.
How long would it take to crush fat to death?
How long?
I don't know, but let's put it to the test.
Watch out for the head.
What are you?
Oh, that's terrible.
Can I just say, I love your country. It's just like the USA, but not as good.
What are these ones?
Okay, an Australian animal, which is also an icon.
What the hell is that?
That's a wombat. That's a wombat.
That's a wombat.
That's a
I've never seen a wombat do that. Pelatophobia is a fear of what? Pelatophobia.
Is that multiple choice?
That'd be yoga.
Pilates, you know?
No.
Pilates.
You should add, it's a fear of bald people. Please make a welcome, Christy Hinds.
That's a great dress. I have an announcement to make. I intend to buy the Newcastle Knights.
Take your passion and make it happen. Ever since I was a young boy, I've played the silver ball. From Soho down to Brighton, I must have played them all. But I ain't seen nothing like this on any amusement hall. That death type of fine kid sure plays me.
God,
speak your love to me.
Well, boys, we're about to pack the set up for another year, but I've got to say,
It has been a great year.
Now, one segment that's just grown in stature to incredible heights has been, yeah, you know it, that's gold. It's gone bananas. It's taken over Australia, then it engulfed the whole world, and it's going for the cosmos. Apparently the astronauts are doing it. It's been amazing.
No, it has been fantastic, but some have been clever and some not so clever. Let's have a look at the that's golds from around the world.
Yeah! Don't pick your nose, kids. This is what can happen.
Jesus. How bad is that?
The theme tonight is about cheating husbands and revenge. Now, this one was sent in over the week.
What about
now, that's
that?
A good get. The boat, all the gear, all over the lawn, that's a good one. Scott Kelly is in the crowd. It's a big game. He's gone with his mates. Now, obviously, he's done the wrong thing by his wife, and she's got the ultimate revenge. Look at that plane. They're two young ladies who love the football show. The first one loves Fatty. The second one wants to have a hot date with Sturlo. Now, this is honest. She's a big fan of Fatty's, and I'm glad she's a fan, because if she wasn't, she's dead set destroy you. Now, this... That's one powerful buttocks. And Sturlo, she's after a date with you, and that's rigid edge. What do you got to say about that?
Well, you wouldn't survive, would you?
This guy, Fat Elvis, is direct from the buffet. He's got everything hanging out, including the hairy beanbags down the bottom. There's a half-price car there. Comes with air conditioning. That's a beauty. Here's the, what about this one? This one's from Ireland, the all-day food, 12 to 9. Yeah, have a look at this bloke playing gridiron. He's Fennec and Barney Gumball off The Simpsons. Now, this is the latest defensive techniques to put off the players in basketball. A little bit of a defensive one. Lick of the armpit, put him off. Now, this is a little bit bizarre. Just in case you like a bit of everything, there's 50 beautiful ones and 3 ugly ones. Only in America I can say this.
Truth in
go to this one. Well, now let's get straight to it. Yuck! Now, kids, everyone watching, slip, slop, slap. That's not speed of football. Well, we've crossed the codes again and we've gone into the AFL. It's amazing. Now, these guys obviously are watching the show. There's the That's Goal of the Swans. And what about this next one you're going to see? It's Melbourne and Collingwood. And it's an amazing one. This is one in the last 5 minutes. Here he goes. This is a dead set. That's goal. Yeah. Look at this. One of the cheer girls thought she'd come out. Greasy conditions. Bang, bang, bang. Oh! Now, that's a backflip. That's a backflip. Good on you, darling. One more look at it. Bang, bang. Oh! We've gone across to England again, and this time it's in tennis, Wimbledon. Check this out. We're over there. Leighton Hewitt's playing Lopez. It's an important game. And that's goal. There it is, my friends. If that's not as good as it gets, I'm not here. Now, have a look at this. The big fella strolls on. The Price is Right. Here we go. Yeah! But we've done it again last week on Monday night on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Check this out. There he is, Michael Ball, parking manager. Let's go! We all know that Matty Johns is a good-looking guy and the women do adore him, but apparently the men do also. Check it out.
Top. Yeah, I do, Gus. The Dragons look more positive. They've got more strike and attack.
Why did he kiss you and not me?
I wonder why.
Why did he kiss you and not me?
Who is that lunatic? Thank God he has some clothes on.
For those of you who don't know, Senator Ursula Stevens is the country Labor Senator for New South Wales and Shadow Parliamentary Secretary for Science and Water. And during her address to the Senate during the week, she said this.
And to all those involved in promoting the wonders of science in National Science Week, as my son would say, Mr. Acting Deputy President, that's gold.
The only one bigger than that is probably to go all the way to the top of the PM. Now, I knew he was at the game last weekend at the Dragons game, and I was wondering if he was going to fall to the power of That's Gold. Let's have a look. Now, there he is giving a nice overhand clap there at the cheer girls. That's pretty good.
An unusual clap.
But then later on in the grandstand, he got caught up with the mood and thought, hang on, yeah, that's gold! Off Bass Strait, I think it was earlier this year, in about 2 kilometres of water, while they were trawling out there, they discovered a new marine animal. It's a new one. They're giving it a whole name. There's a lot of excitement in that scientific area. And unbelievably, when they dragged it up, it's got an uncanny resemblance to one of the boys on our panel. It's dead set. It's a new marine animal. There's a lady here saying that, look, here she is here. The boys are behind me. She was showing off. Look, watch this.
Coming. That's golden.
Prime ministers, A-grade celebrities, divas, wood ducks, they love That's Gold.
And, of course, another huge segment this year was Daredevil dudes!
There's nothing we couldn't conquer. Have a peg at this.
Yeah!
today, we're at the Nevis bungee jump, the third highest in the world, 134 metres of pure adrenaline and fear. And we can't wait to get on there. Sure, I'm all connected? All connected? Ready?
Come on, fat, 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 fat.
Oh, why? 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 Great. Yeah, it's terrific.
Oh. That was mate.
Not good.
That guy's out on one.
Okay, you
ready? Yep. Oh. 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 Yes.
Oh.
Ah. Oh. Here's your big apple.
Is something hanging out the side there, boys?
It's alright. Just give us a second.
No touch. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Mamma mia. Mamma mia. Oh, nuts. Nuts. Oh, nuts. 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 Nuts.
And today, we're goaltending. We're up against some of the Australian Ruse. They are the ice skating champions of the world. And we're going to take them on. We're going to keep the pucks out of the thing. They go at 1,000 kilometres an hour. Look out. Here comes one.
You pussies! Oh.
Oh. Oh. Come on. Shit!
Oh. A backwards jump off a 200 metre.
Oh, yeah, we're
right. Dude, stinks so bad.
Look up.
Indiana fat,
you don't do it. I'm telling you, don't do it. It's terrifying. It's terrifying.
You can't say that to me.
Hey, Phil, Pete.
Feeling very ordinary, Paul. I'm gone.
What?
Yeah. You're a lunatic, you are. Up. I was actually going and you pulled me back. You son of a bitch. I'm going.
We normally do a test run.
I'm going.
Oh, what the hell?
I'm going. You blokes are lunatics.
You didn't tell me I was going to chip over. Oh, no, mate.
We're going to count us. This is one screen, you see this?
No. Oh. Seriously? Seriously? No, no, you.
Here we go. Last screen. See you. Oh! This is some strong shoelace.
Just hold on to this. That's it. Just hold on to that with both your hands.
I don't see why I've got to do this.
Hang on, voice section here. A lot more comfortable.
Well, hang on. Hang on to it all the time. That's not going to break.
No.
That's the main one.
I promise.
Do you have to put me outside to hang upside down?
Yeah.
Why do you want to hang me upside down for over at the end and make me bloody look at it for? Why just can't you put me out from here?
All right, so lift your feet up. Once you're out there, you're going to be feeling all right.
If I get killed, I'm going to come back and get you.
That's it. Push your bum forward.
Oh, jeez, what are you doing? Just sit there. Oh.
Cross your legs.
Oh,
cross your legs over.
Please let me go.
Yeah. Cross your legs over and you're there. Cross your legs over. Arch your back as hard as you can. Chief. Come on, boy. Put your hands straight down at the ground.
Oh, come on. Please. Just let me go.
All right. I'll give you a countdown, okay, Chief?
Just go. That was outrageous.
How good are you, Chief? Geez, you had a great year.
Thanks,
you were fantastic.
Coming up, the fun continues as we look back over the 2005 footy show. We've got Reg Regan, No Talent Time, comedians, plenty of stuff-ups. Stay with us.
You like that, ladies? Yeah.
Three? Yeah, right, three here. Okay. And then you're on to your L5. This is all right, so far. Yeah, pretty good. Can handle this all right, we're up the end.
Don't
you worry about talking, just...
Wise, worse than the bungee here. No. I'm happy to get out.
What are you on, drugs?
What a year! But who could forget the year's lowest point? That's right, when they tried to sack of all people, me.
Well, you've probably heard the news through the week. It's in all the papers. Channel 9 have given Reggie Reagan that. Oh, well, I'll keep my chin up. It's day one and me finding a new occupation. Let's go.
Okay, easygoing, energetic person required for sales position at Willoughby. Bingo!
You're old knife set and you're thinking it just doesn't cut the mustard anymore. Well, you're in for a treat because Reg is here from the Dodgy Dudes to give us an awesome offer on some knives. G'day, Reg.
G'day, Roz. Long time no see.
Beautiful. I've got something today, Roz, that's going to blow your mind. You see this? This is called the Steak Knife 10,000. They used it in the space shuttle. Remember the space shuttle, Roz? Oh, crazy. Just like crazy steak knives. Just watch this. Oh, f***. Have a look at this, Roz. Hey, you don't get up for the miracle blade, do you?
Now, your body is a tool. You got to work it with confidence and precision.
Jeez, we've got a real problem in the car park, guys. Okay, just stay. So,
I knew it was going to happen.
Oh, wait, mate, don't talk to me, Fleabag. Talk to my army. You assholes aren't sacking me. Come on! Come on! Oh, yeah, I'm back and I'm pissed. Yeah! I tell you what, Pat, they could sack Don Burke, but they couldn't sack me. Get that up, yeah!
No, I'm back, baby. Bigger and better than ever. And this year, when they were after a big interview, someone to break the big story, they saw one man, me. Forget about 60 Minutes, forget about A Current Affair, even forget about this Pretenders on Nightline. When there's a big story to be had, it's Reg Reagan.
Just say that I think you are a beautiful looking woman.
Oh, give us a kiss.
Come here. I tell you what, I give more than a kiss. Can you tell the people what they think of the NRL competition at the moment? Yes.
Well, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. Oh, no.
That's okay. Now, you watch the show all the time. You enjoy the show?
Yes, but I don't enjoy it when you kiss the women.
No, no, mate, it's okay. Jessica, just for old time's sake. Jessica, for old time's sake.
Look at that baby face. Look at that baby face. See? He's just a teddy bear down deep.
Very deep. Real goals, like how many shields do you want to pick up? Come on, let's talk about it, Toby.
Mate, I'd be happy to pick up half as many as you do.
It won't happen, though.
Really?
Come here, you old son. Yeah. You old bludgy, you old nut, you old sagger. Yeah. Let me just say something. It feels bloody excellent to have a logie. So come in here, give Reggie a hug, eh? Come on. I reckon you should be Prime Minister of Australia one day.
You're the man, and if I am, mate, I'm going to put you in as the Minister for Cultural Affairs, because you are the man who is actually not only bringing back the biff, but bringing back manhood to Australia. You're a living, breathing example of what we hold dear to our hearts.
Thanks, Eddie. I appreciate that.
Can I just go so far as to say you look bloody fantastic tonight? Give me a kiss.
I reckon Fatty got this. I don't think you got it.
No, mate, I got it.
What do you actually do on that show? Nothing, really. I think Fatty carries it.
Maybe I just...
Don't you think? I mean, look at you. You've got no talent, no style, no class, no brain.
Maybe I should get a start on Big Brother.
Maybe you should.
Well, I'm here today because I have it on good authority that one of the most recognised...
People, can I get some love here, my intense? Because I've been up in my suite for something like 3/4 of an hour trying to make a reverse charges phone call to my missus in Australia. Now, connect me, Sterlo. Why all the smarmy looks? Okay.
We might just go straight
ball
to the tips.
This is how we deal with people in Australia.
Well, have a fabulous
it's okay
week.
Okay, now I just have a bit of an anger problem.
Remember, go Reg, go.
He actually had a phone call from an old teammate of yours who was particularly upset that you were giving it away, and this is what he had to say.
G'day, Robbie. Bob. Mates, when I heard the news that you're retiring at the end of the season, well, I just couldn't believe it. Couldn't believe you were still playing that is. I thought you retired 15 years ago, you bloke. Anyway, mate, I still remember the first time we met, way back in 74, playing for Wests. I was just a youngster coming into grade. You took me in, took me under your wing. I owe you a lot for that. Mate, you're a father figure, a mentor, a great friend, and on one notable occasion after too many beers, a fantastic lover. Anyway, mate, good luck for the future. You're a great friend, a shit footballer, but a great friend.
Boy, it's great working with Willie Nelson, let me tell you.
Willie's a great guy.
No, actually, Willie's amazing.
Sucks or
just
right?
No, Willie's right. The coolest guy, period.
Actually, we're going to pull over the police.
Are we really getting pulled over by the cops?
Yeah. Police.
We're better take the evidence.
How are you, Barjas?
Hey, son, I thought I'd just give you this to
pass on to the boys at Warrington. Let them know what you're all about. Is that all right?
Yeah, it's fine.
Hey, cheers, it's been a one-way ticket. Come on, son, I'll see you out of the country.
Thanks, Reg.
And just got a couple of tits here. I've got a one-way ticket to Manchester via the Ukraine. Excess baggage, I reckon. Yeah, a bit of hand luggage as well.
It's disappointing, but look forward to next year now with the Knights.
It's one of the biggest challenges of your career, Joe, linking up with your teammates that you've never probably seen play.
Yeah, it's been... given the staple diet in England, fish and chips and Yorkshire pudding, can we expect you to see you come back through customs about 180 kilos?
I don't want to answer your question.
Go ahead, son.
Thanks, Reg.
And what are your expectations for this trip?
Well, big James over there, to make a big impact on the side. Just play the best football I can, individually.
Thank you. Yeah, give him a three cheers, eh? Three cheers for Joey, have you? Hey, you and your son will miss you.
This is the captain of Newtown. Harrigan is topping it at the moment, but there doesn't seem to be a lot of respect in the way he's addressing the referee. He'll probably get sent here if he doesn't shut his mouth.
We're lucky we're in the modern age of TV. We're going to listen to what actually went on, and let me tell you something. It shows you what players say sometimes gets misconstrued totally. Have a listen.
What do you want, Skipper?
I just got one thing to say. That, my friend, was a fantastic decision. You are the best referee in the world by a country mile. You're the best. You're the best. And another thing, do you model? Because you should. You are very, very, very good looking. Okay? If I was a female, I'd take you home and have you for breakfast. You're coming to my place for dinner tonight. No questions asked. And you're going to sleep with my wife afterwards. Not once. So, son, just tell Reggie Boy what happened again.
I was leading the team out, and then I got up to there, and I don't know what hit me. Yeah, just a couple of broken ribs, I'll get over it.
Why don't you just point him out for me? Oh, the fat guy there?
Yeah.
Hey, tough guy, have a nice day. Recognise this kid?
No, not really.
What about this? Do you recognise that? Well, this is the kid you nearly killed on the weekend, and I, my friend, are your worst nightmare. Here we go, just give him one. That's it, son. Come on, don't let up, son. That's the way.
Great work, Reg. You're a dead set champion.
Reggie boy. Now, listen, we've gone behind the scenes this year a lot to show you players and supporters that are doing a bit tough. Now, these feature stories really show that there's a lot more that happens in rugby league than you see just on the footy field.
Oh, how lovely you are.
I remember grabbing the hacksaw, got it down, tried to give a bit of mouth to mouth, and actually ran inside. Heaven was upstairs in the house, was in her bedroom that afternoon, and I asked her to ring an ambulance. And I sort of stayed with Letitia until the ambulance got there. And the next sort of day or so was a bit of a blur, you know, just, you know, my whole world was shattered. Everything, you know, that I sort of worked for and with the kids and the family, you know, it was just a bit of a blur for the next few days.
He's worked so hard. I mean, anybody seen him on the football field at 5 years old, playing with a little bit of sand and brushing the field and that. No, he was always gonna be somewhere. He's wanted to be there.
What age was it when it really came clear in your mind that rugby league was gonna be your thing and you wanted to go all the way to the top?
Probably when I was about 16, when my first daughter was coming along, I thought, you know, then if I'm gonna do it, I've gotta do it now. And you know, try and make something for them.
We try and let the kids come once a year, you know, to one of the games. So, yeah. They don't, you know, and they've come right from when they were little to now and gone through that age where they wore their jerseys with their favourite player's name on the back and all those sorts of things.
Good luck, Dad.
Thanks, Dad.
See you, Dad.
See you, Bob.
Realisation of a job well done won't sink in immediately for Choppy. So what will he be like next year?
Oh, I'll probably be angry and cranky and hard to get along with for those 3 weeks, but some people will tell you that's probably what I'm like all the time.
I didn't necessarily go out there to do what I did. That wasn't something that was playing on my mind. You know, it is a contact sport and it does get a bit steamy at times.
Oh, great shot!
As a forward, I think it's one of the most important jobs in the field. The backs wouldn't say so, but those aspects of my game, they make me the player that I am, and I can't change that. And I find that when I'm doing that, I'm more benefit to the team.
Why South? What made you pick South?
Because they can go good.
They
can win it. I want them to win the semis and they can get in it. Mm.
Hey, what about the wooden spoon?
I don't want South to come last again because what happens if they come last? I want Newcastle to come last because they Glenn Johns, and I want Glenn Johns because Glenn Johns played crap. Because that what happened.
Yeah, so you're happy. Yeah. This year, South, no wooden spoon. They're on fire.
Yeah, on fire.
I think it was James Webster. He's a little guy, and I saw he went low on me and sort of went to bump him off and twisted me, and Darren Tracy come over the top and landed on the top of my head and just sort of rotated forward a little bit too much and just heard a few little cracking noises, and I tried to get up and I just knew something was wrong because it just hurt a little bit more than usual.
Yeah, great stories. Now, where are we?
Boys, we're in the control room. This is the engine room of the footy show. Every Thursday night, some very smart people sit up here and they push all these buttons just to try and make us look good.
Billy, you're not playing this week. You took an early guilty plea for an alleged head slam.
Yeah, that's not the reason, Fatty. I got the bye this week, mate.
I mean, some of their players just lifted from nowhere to come good, especially the outside backs. I thought they were... I don't know what I'm talking about. Everyone's entitled to that one... Sorry, I'll get through it this time.
Help me, someone. On behalf of our crew, it's bye for now.
G'day, I'm Steve Irwin, the Crocodile Hunter. Today, we're in one of the most dangerous places in Australia, and it's not the outback. That's right, Steve. It's the backyard barbecue. The dangers here are endless. You have to be on your guard at all times.
Look out, Steve! Duck!
That's a chicken, you goose. Another dangerous creature in the backyard is the redback.
I've never seen one that big before, Steve.
Redbacks get really cranky if provoked.
Don't touch him, Steve. Don't touch him.
Piss off.
Steve's down! Again! Steve, can we eat now?
Okay, Terry, let's get back to the barbie.
Steve, look out! Oh no, Steve's down! Again! Looks like no sausage for him. Or for me. Anyway, until next time, I'm Terry Irwin.
Right, I'm Steve Irwin.
He's the crocodile hunter.
Welcome back as we sneak through the highlights of this year's footy show.
Let me introduce you to the Channel 9 makeup room, and it's really fantastic.
Reg loves this joint.
Well, as you can see, we're total professionals on this show, whether in the studio or out on shoots. Always well rehearsed, always seamless.
Have a look at our fearless leader. He's on a trampoline, everything's great and gone. Oh. I mean, that's...
And I tell you, look at the sympathy from the boys.
I'll tell you how bad I was going. Mario was talking to me and I could understand him. That's how bad I was going.
At the end of this, someone's going to win a fantastic prize at the end of the year, a Mitsubishi... a big Fuso truck from Mitsubishi.
You might have noticed during that ad, just a bit of footage of the chief. It's almost like he was maybe expecting something from Reg there. Just watch him covering up just a little bit early. Now, we'll be able to show you why he was doing that, because just before that, this had happened.
Painful, some of those, oh.
And Chief's still affected, don't worry about that. Now, through the year, we've had thousands of funny guys on the show.
And one not so funny guy.
What's worse than poo? Oh, come on! That's it.
Hey,
you know.
Sometimes you get toilet paper and you blow your nose with it. That piece of toilet paper probably considers itself lucky.
I had a great day today. I went to a bird sanctuary or brothel, whatever you want to call it.
Wouldn't you love to see that? I'd love to see that, like an Indian in a porno. Oh, I'm telling you what, I want to give it to you.
Summer comes as a surprise every year in Australia. We go, geez, it's warm, mate. Are you warm? They always ask you if you're warm just in case they've got a fever or something. You warm? Hey? Warm. Hasn't been as warm as this since last year.
You know what makes me really sick? Everyone thinks that Kung Fu comes from Japan or China. It's not true. Kung Fu started here. My people invented Kung Fu. It started like this long, long, long time ago. There were these two little boys throwing boomerangs around. Catch on their leg behind their back. They were doing some fancy boomerang style. You had a dragon style, there's boomerang style. And the two... While they were throwing their boomerangs around, there was an old man sitting about 20 meters away, sitting around a small campfire with a goanna cooking on it. And the two little boys kept throwing their boomerangs around. And they had traditional names like Jan and Jackie, or Jackie Jan, Jan Jackie, whatever. And one of the little boys, he threw his boomerang that hard, when he let go and released it, the wind changed direction and blew the boomerang towards the old fella. Bang, hit him in the back of the head, knocked him down. The old guy got up rubbing his head like that. He reckoned, all right, which kung fu that?
He's a centre called Willy Tonga. Had a shower with him, his was longer.
AFL's a funny game, isn't it?
It is.
Yep. Mm. Thought you'd say that. The only game out of the world I know has got four posts. Every other game's got two posts. You've got to get the ball in between the two posts. If you don't get in, you don't get anything. AFL, they'll give you something for getting near enough. You kick the ball and go, did it go in? And they go, no, but we can see what you're trying to do.
I was once stranded on a desert island with Elle Macpherson, true story, and we were there alone, me and Elle. I didn't try and crack onto her. You know, I was a gentleman. You know, I caught the food and built a little hut for her. Me and a wog, I concreted the island. And bit of pebblecrete, nice finish, and... Anyway, after a couple of weeks, she went up to me and said, Vince, she said, you know, look, I'm the best-looking chick in the world. How come you haven't tried to, you know, hey, yeah? I said, oh, look, I'm shy. I'm just trying to be nice. She said, forget it, Vince. There's no one here. It's just you and me. Come on, I get horny too. Come on, let's do it. So we did it. And it was pretty good. And the next day, we did it again. Then we started doing it a couple of times a day. Pretty soon, any time I wanted it, hey, Al, hey, on, you know. Well, anyway, this went on for weeks and months, and... One day she woke up, Elle, she turned over and said, Vince, she said, this is great. Not only were you a gentleman to me in the beginning, but I love having sex with you. I think you're fantastic. As a matter of fact, Vince, I think I love you. Is there anything I can do for you? I said, well, thank goodness for asking. There's something I'm dying to do. Well, she said, name it, Vince. I'll do whatever you want. I said, all right. I want you to dress up as a bloke. She goes, ooh, I didn't think Vince was like that. So anyway, yeah, all right. So she gets dressed up as a bloke, stands behind the tree. I walked over, I went, mate, you wouldn't believe it!
Great fun. Now, we've still got No Talent Time Gold, more Reg, a tribute to the fat man. In fact, Fab, I've got to say, when you were down and out, plenty of high-profile messages came in.
Fatty, it is so good to have you back, mate, and with any luck, this little incident has knocked some sense into you.
Hey?
Yes. For a minute there, I thought you were gone.
Oh, yeah. You're back.
And it is good to see you back, but, Chief, you're still my favourite.
And, Fatty, I'd like just to say, mate, that everything is going to be...
Check the pulse. He's got his sumo suit on too.
Fat, you're back. You reckon the fat don't want you back? Absolutely, Fat. There's no footy show without the fat. But unfortunately, I can't afford to have 3 months off, Fat. I've got to get back to work. Good afternoon. Can you hold? Good afternoon, Errol. Can you hold, please?
G'day, Fatty.
Well, Mr. Vorton.
Glad you could make it back from your little holiday. See, a lot of stories going around, man. One of which had lain on a beach in Vanuatu. Someone else told me you're drinking kava in Fiji. A person even came around and told me you got caught with tablets and barley. Crazy! Crazy. Tell you what, mate, it's good to have you back. There's been a lot of pressure on Reggie. You've been carrying the show. Those other three clowns just won't shut up. Anyway, mate, good to have you back. Let's catch up, have a beer and a massage. Good luck.
Hey, welcome back to the best of the footy show.
Now, halfway through the year, it did come as a big shock to us all when our fearless leader had a bad fall, was out of action for 10 weeks. What it did allow us to do was to have a look at some of those great fatty moments which make the footy show what it is.
Disaster's happening in New Guinea with the tidal wave, and we started. What? He's going. No, he's going. There's a camera down there. This one. And it's over here.
Mate, you'll find it. There's only two.
You guys being professional athletes will.
See you, mate. See you, mate.
I got nothing. Now look, Wayne, just on your own year, you must be happy.
I can't wait to hear this question. Finish on.
I'm gonna kill myself, I know, but I'm a daredevil dude! We're not going to solve it here tonight, but to talk about it, please, I'd like you to give a big round of applause to these three.
Where are you going, Paul?
I'm going for the Eels, Peter. I think the fact that Jason Smith is playing five... Got him.
Which way are you going, Paul?
I do like the Eels.
Not funny.
I know.
It's not funny you like the Eels.
I think they'll score plenty of tries, while Cronulla, as far as them scoring tries is concerned, too much dependence on the bomb. Did I say something wrong?
As far as them is concerned.
I think they'll score plenty of tries. Cronulla, as far as them try...
What's wrong?
What's wrong?
I don't know. Slow down. Slow down. Which way are you going, Paul?
The Eels. We were sort of getting in a bit of a rut. And how was I to know that, you know, within 15 seconds I would take probably the greatest catch ever to be seen on a cricket field? That's in the air, who's underneath that one? This is going to be a catch, is it? No! Oh! Oh, great to have you back, Judge Fat.
Thanks, champ. Well, you know, street talk, Matty. Someone from this panel has always been willing to get out in the street and ask the tough questions.
Mate, referees, have we lost respect for authority figures, do you think?
I saw this one on
on TV. Yeah, it's terrible. Yeah. Terrible.
They're throwing cans at referees and all sorts of things. Is that going too far?
Too far, yeah.
Well, how far is too far?
Do you feel a difference around here when the Tigers win?
Yeah, on the day, yeah. Especially straight after the game when it's really crowded.
Yeah, mate. Just rubbing my arse, that bloke. Or was it you?
It wasn't me.
You're proud of these young Tigers at the moment? How well?
Absolutely, I can't believe it. It's amazing. All the way, the Tigers.
Say that again, that was great. Wanker.
I'm with you. Go back to Queensland.
Good day, mate. How you doing?
Pretty well. How are you, mate?
Mate, I'm bloody good.
That's good.
Mate, what about the Eels?
Go the Eels. Dead set losers, actually. I'm actually a Tiger supporter.
Does it make you proud walking down the street as an Eel supporter?
I've been an Eel, mate. I remember the 30-foot Eel walking up this street right back in 1974, mate. Yeah, mate. Bring back the big 30-foot eel, fellas.
Mate, 30-foot eel.
Yeah, mate. Bring it back.
Yeah, mate. Let's get it back, eh? Let's hear about the 30-foot eel. Bring about the 30-foot eel. And what about those Rabbitohs at the moment, eh?
Mate, they're legends. That's my side.
Your side, eh?
Yeah, red and green. Bring green heart, mate.
Been a Rabbitohs supporter, you probably know what this is, then. Hey?
Rabbits, they're doing pretty good. They're all right.
Do you think they can avoid the wooden spoon? I mean, Newcastle are coming home with a wet sail.
I don't know. I think I know where you can stick that.
I think your brother deserves the wooden spoon more than anyone, honey.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, you could break that wooden spoon over his big fat ass, couldn't you? Hey,
what about the big fat head?
Yeah. Oh, geez, that's a bit nasty.
Might run in the family too, eh, bub?
Oh, gee.
Well, you've come into Redfern to ask us about Newcastle. You're in a Newcastle jumper. Go back home, sweetheart. You deserve the wooden spoon.
Why are they playing so well, the Rabbitohs, at the moment?
No place to hide. No place to hide. I've seen rabbits run fast, but they're fast.
Give us a go to the Rabbitohs, Janet.
Okay.
Can you give us a go to the Rabbitohs, Janet, okay?
Yeah, I will.
Now?
What can I say?
Go to the Rabbitohs?
Yeah, go to Rabbitohs.
As fans of the Seagulls, who do you love in the Seagulls? Who should they follow?
Menzies. You can't go past Menzies.
You like the Beaver?
You can't go past him. He's been around forever and he's still doing excellent work. Brett Stewart.
You love the Beaver, don't you, girls? Yeah. Hey, you young girls. Saturday night, the boys went on the buzzer. You're in the finals, guys. Go on, have a hug. Go on. Hey, bloody hell, there you go. Give her a kiss. Hey, go on, slip the tongue in. Go on. No, not her, me. You had a tough day, Rooster?
Oh, really bad.
What's happened?
Well, I bit a piece of toast this morning, lost all my teeth.
Well, girls, I've got one word for you girls.
I got one word.
What?
Actually, it's two. At the Tigers.
That's actually three words. Okay, any single ladies here? They're after some action. CK's your man. Okay. Hung like a Trojan horse.
Tell everybody that man you know the next door mate.
How are you, old son? I like your moustache.
Hey, I like your moustache.
Oh, my good God.
Did anyone ever tell you you look like Don Burke? I'm a son.
You come here. Come here, you.
I know all about rugby league.
I don't know nothing about that much about rugby league. Well, I know a good sort when I see one. You give me a... Might just get lucky tonight, huh? That's all we have to do to knock over St Kilda.
Oh, we have to play some tactics.
What sort of tactics?
Get our forwards going and get our fullbacks going, get them back and all that. So,
just rip into the bastards, don't we?
Yeah,
hey?
Yeah.
Hey, you love it, don't you, son?
Oh, I love it.
Hey, how good is it, son? Okay, I've taught the boys all I know. Now they've invited me in to do the ice bath. Shirt lifter stuff. Let's go and have a look. Well, Reg, mate, you've been on fire this year.
What? Fired? Fired?
You must be joking. I basically control this network. Nobody fires me.
Massive problems in there between these two crocodiles. While they sort that out, let's have a look at some more of our great comedians.
Yeah, I was in a club. Have you heard people say they can tell how you're going to be in bed by the way you move on a dance floor? Like, they reckon they can tell what your rhythm's going to be like in bed by your rhythm on the dance floor? Like, that's why I don't dance. I figure, stuff it, ladies. You can find out the hard way.
Someone said the other day, what job would you be doing if you weren't doing this? I know what job I'd like. If I wasn't doing this, I'd like to be the bloke who moves the arrow on the bushfire warning sign. That's a day. It's a big day, that one. Smart guy. And then he'd come home from work and his wife say, how's your day, dear? He says, oh, pretty moderate.
They're fleeing their country, cause they don't want to live in Pakistan,
Afghanistan,
Uzbekistan,
Turkmenistan,
Tajikistan,
Kazakhstan,
Iran,
Iraq,
and New Zealand.
The only place I can sleep is on the plane. I slept on the plane up here. You know, he's one of those sleeps on the plane. And you wake up, you got to do all those exercises, you know, those stupid things. Otherwise you get that disease that sounds like a porno. Deep vein thrombosis. I wouldn't mind a bit of that. Now, people get so excited on the plane. I fly all the time. I don't get excited anymore about anything, really. And this guy, you know, people, they fly for the first time, oh, my ticket, oh. Sit next to me, he says, oh, sorry, can I get through there? Point that friggin' thing the other way, mate. He went, hello. I went, oh, hello. He said, how are you? I said, good. He said, where are you off to? I said, same place as you.
Old MacDonald, he had a farm, E-I-E-I-E-I-O. And on that farm, he had a duck, E-I-E-I-E-I-O. E-I-E-I-E-I-O.
Great to see you two blokes have made up. Coming up after this break, we've got the best of No Talent Time Goal, but first up, one of our award-winning Eddie ads.
Several different ways.
Aha! You busted!
From St. George, he's here to show us his range of home loans.
Sorry, mate, nice to meet
you. The reason I was giving your assets a thorough going through?
He's giving us a loan at a great rate.
At about 2.5%.
Well, anything can be organised. Jump in.
St. George Bank. For that personal touch.
Welcome to that time of the night where no longer is talent enough, where we try to find that undiscovered gem. Yes, it's time for the footy show's No Talent Time Gold. Hosted by our own Nugget of Gold. Take it away, fat man.
Well, Pete, one of my favourite segments on the footy show is No Talent Time Gold.
We've had some absolute superstars again this year. Have a look.
that.
Sniff that, son. There you go. That has the one.
Mate, that's 11.
Max, it's been a long time since we've had a standing ovation on No Talent Tiger. Look like you do a fair bit of practice.
Yeah.
Every afternoon, after the homework.
Nah.
Nah.
They just rang me up today and told me I was doing it. And...
Sweet home Cabramatta, where the toilet lights are blue. You make a deal on every corner, gets it. We'll get the drugs direct to you. Yum Cha keeps on churning. There's always lots to see and do. You see things hanging in the window. We play Spot the Aussie too.
I'm a love stroke, baby, I must confess. Life without you, darling, it's a solid mess. Think about you, baby, give me such a thrill. I gotta have you, baby, can't get my fill. I love you, baby, and I know just what to do.
But I gave you quite a few points because, excuse me, sir, you do look a bit like a chook.
Old MacDonald had a farm! And on that farm he had a duck!
With a duck, duck, there, duck, duck, there, duck, there, duck, everywhere, duck, duck, psst, here and a psst, psst, there, here, psst, there, psst, everywhere, psst. Yeah.
Thank you, footy fans. Give me a break. It's tough up here.
That didn't finish, that's bad luck.
Hey, Dick, I had a blow. I thought you were going to have a heart attack, mate. I just had it off.
You didn't finish it.
Hey, sorry, mate.
Hey,
come over and have a yarn.
Do you want a piece of him? Go on, give it to him.
And it was too slow.
Sorry, Dick.
It was too slow.
The music?
Yeah.
Mate, I could dance like that too if I had 12 schooners under my belt, Dick. All right.
You cut it out too quick.
Dick,
I was only halfway through the song.
I didn't cut the friggin' music, Dick.
It's me, mate. Sorry, mate.
30, 30. Oh, yes.
I didn't cut the bloody music, mate. I don't know what you're talking about, brother.
Hey,
all right.
All right. Someone's grinding.
All right, don't worry, mate.
Oh, Pete, you got something,
Sterling.
Mate?
Sterling. You get a good score here.
Well, you went from dancing, Dick.
But I didn't finish it.
No, you... come here. It's all right. It's all right, mate. Give me a 10, pal. I'll go back.
Well, what about Dancing Dick? He went bananas. He's a superstar. I tell you what, next year, he's going to get a gig full-time.
He'll have his own show here on Channel 9 for sure.
Well, what about some guests on the show this year? We've got some international actors, some superstars, and, of course, some of the bands have been sensational.
Oh, Drag were fantastic. Thirsty Merc, unbelievable.
Hey, my favourite, Jimmy. I think we should invite back Sarah over here and Christy.
Yeah, I thought they were...
Aren't they ringing you up all the time? You're sick of that?
No, Clive James is, unfortunately.
That crocodile from CSI was on, Adam Rodriguez.
Of course, boys, who can forget our P&G show.
One in a million.
Oh, that was the best time.
Mate, I'll tell you what we are forgetting. What about one of our favourites in the panel, Mario Fenech? Muzza.
Mario.
Look, the caravan went, but in 2005 he was as big as ever, and he's the best of the beloved Golden Falcon.
Now, what about Gladiator 2, right? And we feed Fatty to the lions. That would be a good script, wouldn't it?
Yeah, keep going. You're good at this comedy stuff. No, just because people aren't laughing doesn't mean that you're not good at comedy.
He's rock solid.
Who for?
To Jamie, you have to spell the word courteous.
C
O. Oh, I got her.
U R T E O U.
Well, you can't pay that.
S?
Yeah! Now, I wonder how hard my word's going to be, Fat. It's going to be an easy word to spell,
it's
Fat.
It's an easy word. Separate.
S-E-P-E-R-A-T-E.
Oh,
S-E-P-A-R-A-T-E.
All right, Mario. Your word is axolotl.
Can we turn the...
A-X-O-T-O-L-L.
One of your best.
You saw it, you can't even spell that right. It was on the screen.
Can you get on the board? Do you think the big fella get on the board?
This is to get you on the board for messing with Mario for the first time this year.
Okay.
It's an easy one. Cephalgia. It's actually a headache. A headache which you're giving us a cephalgia all over the place.
fat. Say it again.
Cephalgia.
Seth, let's go with a start.
Break it up in little pieces,
mate. That's my tip. Little pieces.
He's gone.
Can you get the first letter, at least?
S.
Gone.
Oh.
Right, right, Mario, it's your turn.
Yeah, but I could get hurt. I could get killed.
Who cares?
Who cares?
I wish I hadn't made him do this.
Oh, please, God, help me. Oh, no. Oh.
Now listen, I know what else you've been doing in the off season. You've been singing. You've actually got a hit. There you are.
No
there.
One's told me about this.
Let me love you, Mario.
This is
that's number three. And
so this is something I didn't know
it's
about.
It's unbelievable. You've got does so that look many quite talents. Great? This is the DVD, which is out at the moment.
Solid as a rock, boys. Funny how no one told me about this, mate.
This well, you're recorded it, you should know about it.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, listen, mate, you must be proud of this work. Sensational movie.
Did you get to see it?
No, I haven't seen it yet. but my oldest friend. My south side. My rep side. My backside. My heartbeat. My heartbreak. My life happens here. My card is American Express.
My card now, dickhead.
My life, my reputation.
I can sense you right eating.
Oh, you're good.
I can see marriage.
Thanks, Scoop.
I think you have erection problems.
Mate, I can break up a dogfight under a truck from 20 paces.
Money problems?
Multis.
Multi-millionaires. Mate, that's it. You have got no idea.
Outrageous.
I knew you'd say that.
I knew you'd walk away.
What I won't tell you about is that twerk.
What f***ing twerk?
I sense you need your husband.
Well, fellas, that's it. It's been an amazing year. It's been a big show, mate.
It's been a great show.
Yes, Chief. Thanks very much. A big thank you's got to go to the players and, of course, the clubs. The show would be nothing without their cooperation. Of course, the viewers at home have had a lot of fun.
Yeah, we've had a good time, but I can't remember a better season for rugby league.
Pete, it's been an enormous year. Now, you and I, the work never stops. We've been up in the editing room putting together this highlights package just to show you at home how skillful, how tough rugby league players are. Thanks for watching this year. We'll be back with a footy show bigger and better than ever in 2006. Bye for now.
I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain, the only thing that's real. The needle tears the hole, the old familiar sting. Try to kill it all away, but I remember everything. What have I become? My sweetest friend. Everyone I know goes away in